Good evening friends, I hope you all are doing well in your life. The topic for today's discussion is going to be about history of raw. Yes gentlemen, you heard, the history of raw. And the reason why I have chosen this topic is because after that unfortunate incident that happened in Hindwara district of Jammu Kashmir, where we lost our brave soldier, after that question is being raised on the agency of raw that they are not working properly. So that's why I would like to tell you the history of RAW, where you can completely blindly you can trust on RAW and how it's worked and how it was formed. You will get to know in this video. So without wasting much of the time, let's start the discussion. Earlier it was seen that this RAW was not there. We have another agency named called IB, which stands for Intelligence Bureau, and the first director of that IB was Sanjeev Pillai. And at that time, after the independence, after the independence, we have this IB, and that unfortunate happened. The unfortunate incident that happened in 1962 war, that we lost that war, and after that it was found that this intelligence bureau was not working properly. So it was the need of an hour that we need a strong agency which can fight against all the clandestine activity being conducted by all these terrorists can be find out. So at that time in 1962, this RAW was established, and at that time the PM was Indira Gandhi, and the first director of RAW at that time was R.N. Rao. And the student must also know that the pioneer who were the first one, that there were only 250 people who become the RAW agent of that time. At that time it was found that only army personnel were there who were recruited as RAW agent. Now there are other five child agencies also that work parallelly with this RAW. Name, you should also know the names of that agencies. First one is the Aviation Research Center. Second one, National Technical Research Organization, Electronic and Technical Services, Radio Research Center, and the fifth one and the last one, that is Special Frontline Forces, which work in the areas of border directly. So as I was talking about that, there are n number of mission which they have successfully come up with. They have failed the enemy activities with their agents, with their clandestine efforts. So I would like to name few of them that you can recall it, and and the effort which was made by this RAW was completely a game changer, Operation Meghdoot, Operation Cactus, Operation Chanakya, and this was only possible due to this RAW only. And in the Kargil also, this RAW plays a vital role in that too. It was also a game changer. And if I talk about Indian geography also, in 1975 Sikkim was not a part of India, and it was RAW only which helped us to become a part of this India, to help us to become this Sikkim region, become a part of our India only. So if I talk about the famous RAW agent that student must also know, was Ravindra Kaushik, who was also named as Black Tiger. He was the biggest, you can say an idol RAW agent who fight against or find out all the clandestine activity which was brought by other countries to defeat us. So he found out all the activities. So this was all about RAW and about his history. I hope you loved it, and I want that the people should not question on people that all these elite forces, all these elite agencies are working properly or not. They are working aptly. All we need is that we should support them, and we should help them, that we all stay together with them, we stand together with them. This will definitely help them to fight and to save our motherland. So this was all about today's discussion. I hope you like my video. Thank you and have a nice day. Take care of yourself.